Translation. Prahlad Maharaj continues, one may possess wealth, an aristocratic family, beauty, austerity, education, sensory expertise, luster, influence, physical strength, diligence, intelligence, and mystic yogic power. But I think that even by all these qualifications, one cannot satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead. However, one can satisfy the Lord simply by devotional service. Gajendra did this, and thus the Lord was satisfied with him.
Manne dhanami janarupa tapasya तेज प्रभाव बल पौरुष बुद्धि योगा नाराधनाय भवन्ति परस्य पुंसो भक्त्या चुतोष भगवान गजदूत पाया सो दीज आर मेटीरियल एसेट्स इट्स नॉट वर्किंग Wealth, dhana. Nobody can captivate Krishna by all these material possessions. These are material possessions. Money, then manpower, beauty, education, austerity, mystic power, and so on, so on. There are so many things. They are not capable of approaching the Supreme Personality of God. Krishna personally says, Bhaktya mam abhijanati. He doesn't say all these material possessions, that if one is very rich man, he can have my favor. No. Krishna is not a poor man like me, that if somebody gives me some money, I become benefited. He is self-sufficient, Atmaram. So there is no need of any help from anyone else. He is fully satisfied, Atmaram. Only bhakti, love, that is required. Bhakti means to serve Krishna, that is without any purpose. Ahoituki apratihata, that bhakti. Unalloyed, unnavilasita sunnam, jnanakarma anamritam. Everywhere, this is the statement of this shastra, that bhakti should be unalloyed. Unnavilasita sunnam jnanakarmadanabhritam anukullena krishnanusilanam bhakti yuttam sarvapadhi vininmuktam tatparatena nirmalam rishikena rishikesa sevanam bhakti yuttam. There are so many other definitions. And if we have bhakti, love for Krishna, then we don't require huge amount of money or strength or education or austerity, nothing of this. Krishna says, Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam Jumi Bhaktya Pradacchati. He doesn't require anything from us, but he wants everyone that because he is part and parcel of Krishna, he wants to see that everyone is obedient to him, everyone loves him. That is his aspiration. Just like the father is a very rich man, he doesn't require any help from his son, but he aspires that his son should be obedient and love her. That is his satisfaction. That is the whole situation. Krishna has created Eka Bahushyama. We are Vivinnaṃsa, Mamaivāṃsa Jīva-bhūta, part and parcel of Krishna, every one of us. So everyone has got some duty. Krishna has created us expecting something to be done by us for satisfaction of Krishna. That is bhakti. So that our opportunity is obtained in this human form of life. We should not waste our valuable time in any other occupation or business. Simply inquire and be ready how to serve Krishna. Anukullena Krishna. Anukul. Not your satisfaction, but Krishna's satisfaction. That is called anukul, favorable. Anukullena Krishnanusilanam. Anusilanam means activity. Not that in trance I am in meditation. That is also something is better than nothing. But real devotional service is activity. One must be active. And the best activity is to preach the glory of the Supreme Personality of God. That is the best activity. Nacha tasmat manusyesu kaschit me priyakritam. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.